Okay, we're with Michael Mabasu from Etunyatsi Tours and Safaris. They're a unique tour operating company based in Swaziland. So, Michael, tell us a little bit about what you do and what's unique about your company.
Etunyatsi Tours and Safaris is a tour operating company based in the Kingdom of Swaziland, offering cultural tours, safaris to game parks, with a unique and special attention to detail in terms of the visitation to attractions. But mainly our main interest is tailor-made tours, where your specific interest in terms of our unique culture, the reed dance, the Marula festival, the Ingwala ceremony, which are all unique. We would provide you, obviously, special gateway to the never seen places behind the scenes of what happens in there. Okay. But more importantly, it is being able to offer a unique product to an international visitor,
okay,
in Europe, Asia, overseas countries. And then we are looking forward, obviously, as a company, with the new airport, Kupe International Airport, that has just been completed. We are looking forward to a more bigger market where we have direct flights from overseas. We've just had the Airbus company signing an MOU with the Emirates, so we are keeping
which is very exciting.
Very exciting, obviously. And then if we get international flights, then we are able to get the clients firsthand. We are the ones that are going to welcome them, and then we are going to be able to distribute them to whichever destination in Southern Africa. It is happening for now.
Good. So the Kingdom of Swaziland Tourism Authority is working quite hard to ensure that Swaziland's future as a destination stands alone. It doesn't have to feed so much off the neighboring countries then. You want Swaziland placed as a destination, yeah?
Very much so. Okay. Yes, the Tourism Authority, as you can see, the stand here, as colorful as it looks. Okay. The Swaziland Tourism Authority is the mother body doing all the marketing and the presentation of the true picture of the Kingdom of Swaziland as a destination, not as a transit point. Swaziland is a small country, but it's a very big. You can spend at least 5 days without even finishing all the attractions within the country.
Okay, so good. That's a good 5-day safari, and that you would do a combination of, as you said earlier, cultural and safari.
Safaris, scenic beauty, adventure, shopping.
Brilliant. Fantastic. Well, Michael, thanks very much for spending just that brief moment with us, and we wish you all the best in 2012.